Beyond the Mic with Sean Dillon.
We're joined on the star line by a best-selling cookbook author and food author. She has a franchise of cookbooks that surround the world of fantasy. Her latest is the Star Trek cookbook. We welcome Chelsea Monroe Castle.
Hi, thanks so much for having me.
Chelsea, let's go beyond the mic. You love art.
Yeah.
Food is just another canvas for you.
It is.
Tackled historical and food from fiction. Why was this the next frontier for you to tackle?
Oh, I see what you did there. Well, I've always been a Star Trek fan, and it is such an incredibly rich world with so many diverse cultures that it's been on my sort of dream project list for many years. So when I finally got the call asking if I was available to consider it, I said, here's my suggestion list already of things I think should go in the book. And yes, I will write it for you.
Already prepared.
Oh, yes.
You say in your book, quote, the examination and careful consideration of food as a key component of diplomacy is so vital, unquote. How does tackling these recipes and making them fit their cultural and galactic importance make you feel?
It's a lot of pressure. You know, it's an honor in many ways to be able to work on expanding, albeit in a very small way, these fandoms. You know, I've tried to tackle answering very small questions about different foods and how they relate to the history of Star Trek, like the little food cubes. And it's just been a really fun journey in many ways. I know that because the fans are numerous and very detail-oriented in many cases, I know that the pressure is on for something like this. And so I really try to give it my all and deliver a recipe collection that hopefully fans will love.
Now, with all these universe fans, they're very particular, very inattentive on what is canon.
Yep.
Do you have any fears of messing up, or do you say, hey, this is the way I see it, deal with it?
Well, those same fans are the ones who actually, in many ways, make collection like this possible, because they're the ones updating the Wikipedia entries for all the foods, all the dishes, all the alien cultures we see over the 50 some years of Star Trek that we've had so far. And so, you know, if I need to see if there's an online visual reference, I can go to the Wikipedia article, the Memory Alpha, and say, all right, so where do we see this? And they say, oh, well, it's in this episode of Enterprise. And so I pull up that episode and I skim through it until I find the dish. And sometimes we see it, sometimes we don't. But wherever it is seen on screen, I always try to match it visually to what goes into the cookbook.
Chelsea Monroe Castle, author of the Star Trek cookbook, joins us beyond the mic. Chelsea, it's time for the Rocking Eight. All it is 8 random questions. Answer with the first thing that comes to your mind. There is no pressure. I give you the option, live and animated. Which is your favorite of all the Star Trek shows?
Lower Decks. I love something about all of the Star Trek shows is the longer answer, but Lower Decks is a love letter to all of them. And I do not get tired of laughing with that show. It's just, it makes every day a little better.
Now, you are influenced by your travels and childhood memories. Where was your first trip that you remember taking?
First trip? That is a good question. We went to a cottage in the Finger Lakes when I was a kid.
Ooh, that's cool.
And it was always just like lovely, lazy summer days there, swimming and hammocks and sunshine and things like that. But notable food features included Concord grape pies.
Delicious.
Really good ice cream stand nearby. And we grew a lollipop tree as children near the deck, which as an adult, I recognize I should have maybe figured that out a little sooner, but you also got lollipops out of it. So you know what? Not gonna question.
What is the recipe from your grandmother that you have to perfect before you die?
Oh my goodness. You are really just swinging for the fences. All right. Well, my one grandmother always had a tray of gin-soaked raisins on the counter. That's not really a recipe, but
who cares?
Highly recommend as for the arthritis. The other grandmother, she was always very proper. So I think that she brings to the table, pun intended, just sort of a love of presentation. So I can't think of a specific, chocolate fudge on ice cream. Yeah. Hot fudge sauce.
Where's the best place in Turkey for food?
Ooh. I lived on the Black Sea. And so they had these amazing little crispy fish called hamsi and open-faced pide with an egg cracked on top.
Where have you had the best mead?
Best mead, Penzik War. It's an SCA event festival in Pennsylvania every year.
What three food items are in your bag of holding?
How are we supposed to get through these with such good questions? Three food items. Maldon salt. It's probably all spice blends. Medieval poudre forte. Goldfish crackers for snacking.
What is the best type of bacon?
Burnt almost black.
I can agree with you. Nobody likes flaccid bacon. What's your favorite Elder Scrolls class?
I played a bunch of different characters. I was mostly a hunter, I think. I always wanted ranged attacks so that I could get away and go look at more food.
Well, what's the most sea salt caramels you've had in one sitting?
6 or 7, probably.
It's time for One Big Question with author Chelsea Monroe Castle, author of the Star Trek cookbook Beyond the Mic. Chelsea, you've covered Star Trek, Star Wars, and many other worlds. But what's the one food that has your number and you can't seem to conquer?
Ooh. Meringue has always given me trouble. I would love to really dive into that when I'm between cookbooks and kick its butt.
What recipe did you want to include in the book, but Starfleet didn't want to cause a crisis with its release?
The one that got away for Star Trek was the Jumja sticks from DS9. I made them once, they were perfect, and I did not take good enough notes, so I have no idea what I did, and I could never replicate it.
She likes burnt bacon, loves food from the Black Sea, and still trying to perfect those gin-soaked raisins. Her book is the Star Trek Cookbook. We thank author Chelsea Monroe Castle for taking the time to talk with us today.
Thank you so much for having me.
And that, my friends, is a Beyond the Mic shortcut.